मॉर्निंग माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ नवनीत कौर एंड आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू इंग्लिश लिटरेचर इन योर सिक्स क्लास. एंड टूडे लेट स्टार्ट विद अ न्यू चैप्टर, नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 5, इंडिया एट प्ले, पेज नंबर 28. दिस इज अ चैप्टर अबाउट द गेम्स विच आर प्रिवेलिंग फ्रॉम द पास्ट अप टू द प्रेजेंट टाइम इन इंडिया. When we think of sports, games like cricket, football and tennis come to mind. We rarely think of games such as kabaddi, gilli danda and kit-kit, though they have been with us for the centuries and are played enthusiastically in almost every village and city of India. What are these games? Where do they come from and what do they mean to us? Let us get a knowledge about the games which people of our country played in past. They are very famous games in past. Some are still, like a kabaddi is famous nowadays, but most of the our new generation is not aware from that, our previous sports. Today's only students or our new generation kids just stuck with cricket, football and tennis. But let us get more knowledge about our cultural games. So let us read. On this first page it was explained about the game, first game. Like in the history of humankind, sports have been played an important role for body as well as mind. Even in ancient times, health and fitness of the body had an equal importance as nowadays. Games like kite flying, kabaddi, kho-kho were played by people of all classes of society. Some of these were also existed before Mahabharata, even though those games do not boost stars like Sachin Tendulkar, Mary Kom, but these are immensely popular even today also. Clear this? This is whatever is there in the first paragraph I have explained to you. Next, one by one they have explained the games. First is Kho-Kho. Kho-Kho is one such example, a game of great agility and alertness in ancient times. It was played on ruts and chariots. It was also known as Rathira. Okay, underline this. In modern version, the chaser from one team tries to touch an opponent from the other team to get them out. Chaser may pass his or her task to a teammate sitting on the center line made on a rectangular field by touching the teammate back and shouting "Kho." The team head takes the shortest time to dismiss its rival win. And so this is about Kho-Kho. Here are two, three tough word meanings. Commoner, agility, Chakravyuh. Commoners means common people, agility means swiftness. And Chakravyuh means a complex battle formation that is difficult to break. So here on the right hand side, written about games. Games has been a part of life in India since time immemorial. Many games have originated in India and some are being reinvented today. So Pro Kabaddi League, which was prevailing nowadays, while the Indian Premier League has doubled the enthusiasm of cricket. So the sporting scene in India is vibrant today as we experiment with the old and create new and exciting possibilities. Second is Kabaddi. Yes, it is said to have originated from the Mahabharata incident of Abhimanyu getting trapped in Chakravyuh created by his enemies. Kabaddi is a game of breath control, raiding and dodging. Raiding means entering the area of opposing team. And dodging means avoiding by moving quickly and come back safe on your own area. So, a player raids the opposing team, tries to touch an opponent and return to his or her team, all the while chanting Kabaddi, Kabaddi and holding the breath. At the Asian Games so far, India has always won gold medal in Kabaddi. Kabaddi is also famous nowadays like Kho-Kho. Next one. Another popular sports dating back to ancient time is wrestling. wrestling also come. The Mahabharata mentions Duryodhana and Bhima as accomplished wrestlers. The most famous freestyle version of wrestling in India is Kushti, underline this, which symbolizes bravery and strength. Pehalwans or wrestlers generally practice in akhadas or wrestling schools and dangals. Annual village competition decide a new champion every year. Underline the famous Indian wrestlers name Sushil Kumar, Geeta Fogart, Babita Kumari. There was also a film based on Geeta Fogart and Babita Kumari. In India, sports has also a role in celebration of festivals. Kite flying. Fourth one is kite flying. Or it is also known as Patangbazi. We will continue with this kite flying in a second part of video.